Hello, members of St. Joseph's Church in Danville, Pennsylvania. My name is Jeff Mann. I'm sitting in Lipa City in the Philippines. This is Nanay Basi, Grandma Basi. She lives here. The money that you gave to help us in our project, I thought I'd show you a little bit about where it's being used. One of the big projects that we're doing here this year is to help rebuild Nanay's house. And you're seeing it in progress. If you look over my shoulder, you can see the house in progress being rebuilt. Before they put up new walls and new roofing, it's not going to keep out the rainy weather very well. And you'll see some pictures later on of what the house looked like before. But I wanted to introduce myself. I wanted to introduce Nanay and let you know that your money is being used in ways that help people an awful lot. We really appreciate your generosity in supporting our program. And so the rest of this video is going to be an opportunity for you to see the sorts of work that we do and the sorts of people that your money has gone to help. So thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the video.
Our trip to the Philippines was an experience like no other. After a semester of studying the Filipino culture with Dr. Mann, our team of six Susquehanna University students traveled to the other side of the world to see the sights, meet new people, and have the adventure of a lifetime. But it wasn't all fun and games. In many areas of the Philippines, the conditions are harsh, to say the least. Employment is elusive. The poverty is more astounding than anyone can imagine. In the countryside, many people live in huts and shacks. While in the city, many people live on the streets and in alleys. Some even live on landfills, trying to make a living, sifting through the rubbish, looking for anything of potential value. As Americans, we begin to realize just how fortunate, perhaps even spoiled, we sometimes are. We also became much more aware of our obligation to help our less fortunate brothers and sisters. Scripture tells us that to whom much is given, much is expected. We are called to feed the hungry, heal the infirmed, and shelter the homeless.
So what they're doing, and we're helping a bit with, is removing the old walls, clearing out the floor. They're going to put up these new walls, new framing for the walls, and then they're going to pour a new floor, put down soil first to raise up the floor because of the flooding, and then put cement on top of that. So that's the plan.
I almost pulled this nail out over here earlier, and everyone laughed at me because I didn't know that that was the only thing holding the roof up. What?
Helping to rebuild Nanay Basi's house was one small way in which we were able to make a difference. And it was your contributions that made it possible. Your generosity also enabled us to purchase 9,000 pounds of rice, which went to feed many hungry and happy little mouths. All of us on the PLUS program agreed that it was quite possibly the best 2 weeks of our lives. We laughed together, and we cried together. We made friendships we will always cherish. And we learned lessons we will never forget. For those of you who have contributed to the PLUS program in the past, from the bottom of our hearts, we thank you. Please know that your donations and your prayers are truly appreciated by those who desperately need it most. As our Lord said, "Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me."
And see that all the best is still to come, and I know life ain't easy. I pass them sleeping on the streets, the bloodstained hands and dirty feet, and I can't ignore them any more than I already hear.